Welcome to Juniper Cloud Metro AMA series, where we have experts to answer your questions, any questions related to next-gen metro networks. I'm your host, Irene Zen, Director of Product Marketing at Juniper. Joining me today is Amit Bhatwaj, Senior Director of Product Line Management at Juniper. Amit, welcome.
Today we have another question. What's the difference between cloud metro versus traditional metro?
So we'll start with three big pieces, right? One, as you move to the cloud metro architecture, there's going to be new capacities required in the network. New capacity means new speeds and feeds. You know, we're talking about 10 gig, 25 gig, or 100 gig unis, 400 gig NNIs. We're going to talk about, you know, integration of the optical with ZR and ZR Plus pluggables into the capacity, into the routing platforms. We're also going to look at new protocols in this scenario with going towards EVPN and segment routing as the driving infrastructure from a protocol perspective, while also supporting some of the traditional protocols, because you know we're not going just greenfield, so there will be some brownfield to greenfield scenarios, and this is where, you know, for example, Juno's stack comes into play, you know, where we are able to support both the traditional and the next gen protocols into the Juno stack. The timing is going to become a lot more critical in the infrastructure because of the low latency use cases. So that's the infrastructure piece. Now, when you start to look at the one layer above from an intelligence standpoint, you're looking at this network architecture where the traffic needs to be steered wherever the service is being delivered. The service might be delivered at the cell site, one hop from the cell site, or maybe two hops from the cell site. And these workloads, you know, might move within the metro locations. So the intelligence in the IP fabric to have this capability to steer the traffic wherever the service is being delivered is going to be critical. Right? Now, as you start to converge all the different use cases into the common infrastructure, that converged network requires certain set of requirements when in the automation layer. Because underneath, you can use the same protocols for delivering your broadband services, you're building your 5G infrastructure, or you know even doing things like you know, separation of control plane, user plane for certain applications, driving the traffic to different workloads. But as you drive all these use cases, now how do we manage the network infrastructure? And this is where network slicing comes into the play. Because network slicing basically is a technology that we use some of the VPN and the for the overlays and segment routing or MPLS for the underlay from a technology standpoint. On top of that, we look at the quality of service attributes to guarantee some of the SLAs for this, along with latency in the network. But the big piece of this is like, how do you orchestrate this, right? That's why automation becomes key, is that you know, orchestrating this workflow for network slicing, where you can set up your network slices, you can set up your you know, overlays on the network slices, and then you can assure each of these network slices in an automated fashion, and then do a closed loop automation around that. I think this is the automation infrastructure that's going to be required to migrate towards a cloud metro architecture. So let me just summarize this thing again, right? New capacity and architectures, you know, intelligence in the network fabric, and the automation, you know, to drive the all the use cases on a converged network, basically. So that's just of, you know, how this is going to happen in the service provider space.
What else do you want to learn about the next generation metro networks? Send us your question by email at metroama@juniper.net. And join us at our monthly live AMA session. You can find a date and registration link at the description box below. See you next time.